All right, welcome back to episode 3, I believe, of our dear friend Alice and her harrowing adventures in the land of Wanda. We're still wearing steampunk. And we're getting some pretty exciting stuff. Oh, the kitty cat.
Monsieur, a cat has 9 lives, that is.
I hope you have as many. Oh no, I need to make it float away, young bird. Okay, so this is gonna be a little bit of a shorter video. Because I am doing this before I go to work again. I should really not do that, because then I can spend more time on it. But I really want to play the game and record, so I'm going to do that. Something really shitty happened where I was uploading. Oh my gosh, oh god. I was uploading the, oh god, how far do they jump? I was uploading, or not uploading, but I was exporting episode 1, and it got stuck at 100%, and basically what happened was, it got stuck, and then I go to see if it's downloaded, didn't download properly, so I go to open up the project and start exporting it again, and guess what? It's completely gone. I'm not sure how to fix that problem, so it's not that bad because, this series, it says in the title, it's uncut, so we're not doing much editing anyway, so it's not that bad to just redo it. It takes, half an hour to put all the gunk together and then export it. But yeah, that was kind of annoying, not gonna lie. That was really quite a bummer. So I'm coming in hot, guys. I'm coming in hot on this episode. But I do have a couple topics that I want to talk about. Last time we spoke about aliens very lengthily and not much content. It was just me sort of fumbling around. Oh, this is the rat mouse?
Annoyance.
Ooh.
Some like it hot, but no one likes it this hot.
That's so fucking weird. So my sort of topic for today, or this episode, is going to be anime. So, first of all, it's not loved by everyone. It's misunderstood by a lot of people. I do watch it. I've watched a bit of it. How do I... Oh, can I block it? Yeah, bitch. I've watched the main ones. I haven't really watched a lot of the niche ones that I'm sure people will be like, oh, you know, if you like anime, you should watch this. And I probably should. But I watch the main ones. I find that they are easy to watch. Oh, fuck off. Oh, please make it. Please make it. So I'll start by saying I watched, primarily, I started with Naruto and One Piece and, they were awesome. I sort of grew up with both of those when they were... Oh, no, 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 no. It's hot, it's hot, it's hot, it's hot, it's hot. Why is it still hot there? I'm sure I'm not supposed to go on these. Oh, maybe I am. No, I'm supposed to go over there. What the fuck? I dodged. Oh, my God. You're kidding me. Fuck this. God damn it. Me and my distractions. Can I just jump across? Okay, I can. Yeah, so I watched those ones. I grew up with those ones. I hate this fucking dodge system. It's so bad. I grew up with One Piece, with the Monkey D. Luffy and his pirate crew. And Naruto when they were kids. You know, so it was kind of interesting because it was similar to like my experience with Harry Potter, which is a weird tangent. But with Harry Potter, I was like the same age as the actors when they started the film. So that was interesting to me, is that I grew up with I grew up with that. So I did like those ones mainly. I've gotten into more recently. I started watching, I watched Death Note, I watched the Attack on Titan, which is a great one. I'm watching Soul Eater right now. It's pretty interesting. I watched Sword Art Online, just kind of like the mainstream ones. I found that in the past few years that Netflix has been a great source of anime or that sort, you know what I mean? I think that they are, that's like, if you're interested but sort of like haven't watched any, go on Netflix. I mean, Netflix is pretty cheap and oh shit, did I fuck up? No, because I can walk on this, right? Yeah. It's a great place to start. So give that a try. Oh shit. Give that a try if you're interested, and I think it's a pretty good place to start with anime. Attack on Titan is good. I really like that one. It's very adult. Death Note was really good as well. I enjoyed that one. I would say those ones are a bit more adult themed. Yeah, so that's one of those things. Another thing I wanted to sort of talk about with anime is the sort of stigma, at least when I was growing up with, you know, when I was a teenager, it was new to, well, at least Canada. United States, I'm not sure. I can't speak for them. But, in Canada, when I was, you know, 14, 15, 16, we had, like, the dub versions of, like, the early stuff, but we all, like, we didn't have Netflix or anything like that, so we were watching One Piece, Naruto on, like, YTV and those sort of, stations that provided that. Where the fuck am I supposed to go? Okay. Oh, Ventacular. So that... Oh, take that, Pathless. Oh, you heat it back up, eh? Alright, alright. Your new leader, Dormhouse. Oh, it's hot. It's getting hot in here. So I found that was sort of an interesting thing back when we were in high school, was like, if you, it wasn't, you know, popular, it wasn't cool to watch anime, and I did, you know what I mean? Like, it was sort of like, that's kind of weird, why would you watch anime? That's like it's a Japanese thing, you know. Usually it was associated with kids who were nerdier or geekier or less popular in that sort of sense, which is a very negative stigma. Like, it was, I can honestly say that, like, sometimes I felt like ashamed that I was watching it, which is totally unreasonable, because you should just be like happy that you enjoy something, that you gain pleasure for someone else's art form. So Like, that sort of came in later when I became more independent as an adult. I was just like, fuck what everyone else says. Like, this shit's awesome. So yeah, if you're ever thinking of that stigma, just ignore it. Like, just watch whatever you want to watch. Do whatever you want to do, for the most part, within legal rights. Don't just go murder people. That's not good. But yeah, so that was a kind of an interesting thought process when I was, oh, they have all pads, like maxi pads. It was a negative stigma, and it kind of sucked because I wanted to watch more, and I wish that I did. I wish that I embraced it a bit more when I was younger, because, you know, now it's like so relevant. It's so understood as an art in like our culture now. Like, it's just similar to video games, where it's like, I'm so stoked that there's so many people playing video games and that you can honestly have you can find that most people have now played games or do play games currently. That's really awesome to me, because, like, again, growing up, I'm only 24 years old, so a lot of people had experienced it a lot stronger in their past. But I was sort of on the turning of the tide where it started to become okay in culture. Like, people were like, yeah, do whatever you want, you know, follow your dreams and do whatever you want to do. Like, we're running out of jobs, so you might as well do what you want to do to be creative. And so that was, oh, his arms. That was, where am I supposed to go now? I wasn't paying attention, guys. Oh, shit. I wasn't paying attention. Do I just drop down there as well? I'm guessing so. Yeah, okay. Oh, no need to do it. The game will do it for me. So that was kind of an interesting thing. And so one of the pet peeves, and which is why
we'll make a nice change. Expect no thanks until I'm completely reconstructed. No resting on laurels, chiffoniering.
Shut up. Mean folding chairs. I love how I just started talking when he was talking. It's like ignoring him, like, fuck this guy. I'm gonna talk. I need to retrieve his legs now. I'm gonna talk to myself. Blah blah blah. So where am I supposed to go? Am I supposed to do the same thing? Might as well. So there's this weird thing that I find with anime. And I understand that Japanese culture is different than... Oh, where's the bottle? Japanese culture is different than North American culture. Canadian and American. I understand that. But there are some things that just make me tilt my head. And have that question mark where it's like, I was watching, there's some that, like, a lot of the times the good or bad guys will in those at least the fighting animes, like Soul Eater, certain characters will take traits of an animal, like a cat, and Japanese people think that cats say nyan. Which is fine. I don't know if it's true, but it's whatever. I know I'm supposed to go over there, but how? There's this way. I know I've already just went that way. I need to go this way. Can I jump all the way over there? Yeah. Yeah, so they'll take upon traits of, like, a cat or a frog, and a lot of the times in their speech they will place those monikers or little influences in their voices, like they'll finish words with the sound of or they'll finish sentences with the sound of that animal, the way they think that they make it. Like, frogs say gecko. Where are you, you fucking cat?
The dimensions of this desolate tract are unknown.
Look at his fucking head. So I was watching one where this like chick was a fucking frog person, I don't know, and I can't go that way. So they'd say like ribbit, I guess, would be like gecko, and I just thought it was so interesting, but like very confusing. And so tell me what you guys think, but I think that's very strange. But I mean, all right, that's fucking weird, but it's cool. I don't get it though. That's sort of something that I found that was so interesting, but you never find that in the, you know, North American shows. But I mean, fuck it. I grew up with fucking Saved by the Bell and shit. I didn't grow up with Naruto. Well, I guess I did, but like, not the Japanese one. Oh, coffee in the morning. Coffee's so bad for you, but it's so good. Get addicted, kids. It's fun. Don't listen to me. My judgment is always wrong. Oh, things just... Oh, no. Oh, no. How did I do that? Dodge. I just dodged death. Dodge death. Death dodge. So I guess that sort of, you know, I didn't really write this down as a topic, because I'll come up with a couple topics here and there. So does this one also? No, that one does. They really did a good job on the level design. Holy shit. So I'm guessing I have to go here. This one I might just have to... Nope. Oh, I was close. Maybe I can dodge. Okay, I think I can dodge it. And go. Yeah! Woo! Get some of this shit. Always look for collectibles in the gameplay that people just want to see the story line up. But you want to get all the collectibles because you're a greedy hoarder. And you should just beat the game because instead of it being 14 hours, it'll probably be 18 hours long. That song is copywritten, by the way. So watch anime, give it a try. If you've never tried it before, there's always a time to try. Don't follow the stigma that it's, you know, weird or niche, because it's not. You're always gonna find someone that's, you know, gonna have the similar interest to you. Oh, come on, I dodged that. Oh, maybe you have to go small and do that. You're always gonna find someone that has similar interests in you, so don't feel ashamed at all if you do like this kind of stuff, because I did, and I don't think that it affected me too much, but it definitely stopped me from enjoying the things that I could have enjoyed a lot more. So here's some helpful advice from your nerdy ginger friend here at Full Extension. Just fucking embrace it. Sometimes you just gotta say, fuck it. Just go for it. So yeah, watch anime, it's super fun. If you have any suggestions, let me know. I want to watch more. Motherfucker. But I also don't have a whole lot of time on my hands. And that's the worst excuse, because You should make time for the things that are important to you. I mean, for me, it's like, I try to make sure I have like at least an hour a day of exercise, which is, you know, I already work a job that is physically demanding. I guess I haven't really said a lot about it. I work as a caretaker, or a janitor for layman's terms, and for a school board. And it's just a lot of walking around, a lot of sweeping, a lot of cleaning. So I find that I'm walking like over 13 or 14,000 steps at work, you know, or like a day. And, you know, but I do think that, you know, you should set an hour aside for like fitness, getting healthy. An hour aside for getting healthy, and then an hour aside for learning something or doing something creative. That's what a healthy mind is like. Fuck you, bitch. No, it's gonna... Oh no, it's gonna... Oh, I thought it was gonna do the same thing it did before. Oh no, oh no. Oh, look where you're going, Alice, you dumb bitch. Yeah. Like 2 hours a day seems like a lot of time, which I guess in like some terms it is. But if you do it, I guarantee your life is gonna be sort of more meaningful to you. Like if you actually, oh my gosh, I'm fucking up so hard. You'll find that like, oh my god, I almost got crushed. Should I just like go into fucking berserk mode? Because we spend a lot of our time doing things that are not productive. For example, playing video games. I don't think that's unproductive, but I think that if you play for more than 4 or 5 hours a day sometimes, it can be rough, like without a break. I mean, like, you gotta make sure you're getting out there and taking those breaks, and because that it's so much easier just to stay inside now, eh? It's like everything's catered to, just do it later. You can stay inside and play video games. Look, Steam for PC players. It's the best thing. You could just buy all these games for less than $5 and play them for hours on end. Much to teach us. Fucking Minecraft. Or dead. Stuff like that. So, 2 hours a day. That's all. I work, so I get it. I work and I drive more than half an hour one way, so I'm driving for an hour a day and working for 8.5, so it's like, it does limit your time eventually. Like, at the end, you're just like, shit, I only have 3 hours at the end of the day. Like, do I want to spend two of them not doing things that are relaxing necessarily? But I'll tell you this much. I've preached this before. Like, I went to school for fitness and health promotion. So I am not an expert by any means, but I've done personal training and I've done some diet plans. Not really, like I've given nutritional advice, but I would be way outside my scope of practice. Oh, come on, I thought I could make it. If anyone gives you dietary advice and they're not a registered dietitian, be careful with that, because a lot of the times they are not trained in the art, oh my god, of nutritional advising. Nutritionist is not necessarily I keep on pressing RB, it's our stick. Nutritional advising is very scary, because some people, if you don't know the person's medical, not just background, but if you don't know their body and what they are not only allergic to, but react better or worse too. If you know, some people have a higher insulin response or a lower insulin response to sugar. You know, if you had gestational diabetes, then you might have a higher insulin response to sugar. If you add, you know, it's just stuff like that. That if you don't, if the person doesn't know that, and they're giving you, if a personal trainer gives you dietary advice, like they set a diet plan for you, like eat this many calories of this and eat this many calories of that, you shouldn't go to them. But that's my preaching aside for that sort of stuff. Where am I going? Do I go up there? What are these birds? What is these animals? Can I shoot that? Nope. What the fuck am I supposed to do? I just came from down there. I'm not supposed to go over there. Alright, I'm gonna try and make it. Nope. Where am I supposed to go? What the hell? So, jump up here. Yeah. Oh, here we go. Yeah, don't listen to those people. Anyways, like, I'll say that there's not been one time where I've gone to the gym and I've regretted it. You know, every single time I've gone for a run and then gone to the gym or did a workout after, went to the gym itself, like, there hasn't been one time where I've been like, oh, that sucked. It's sort of like, you know, it's so rewarding, and the sort of the DOMS, the late onset of muscle soreness is such a good feeling.
But my warning goes unheeded, so without regret, you're about to feel like a lobster.
I don't understand a word he's saying. I don't speak Scottish. Oh, he's jerking it. All right. Oh, getting close to the mic. I gotta get a mic stand or something. Ooh. Yeah. So that was sort of my part of advice. No one needs to listen to it, but I don't know. If you feel like it, go for it. I'm not a doctor. Oh, yet. I'm kidding, I'm not gonna be a doctor. I do plan on going back to school, though. I do plan on, oh, motherfucker, I hate these goddamn slugs. I do plan to finish my undergrad in kinesiology. Maybe become a physiotherapist. Who knows? Who knows? Alright, a few more minutes. We're at, like, almost 30. I'm gonna keep this one a little bit shorter, because I gotta shower, because I'm a stinky, gross little boy, before I go to work. Oh, the coffee is running through my vein-taculars. Where am I didn't see that. Where am I supposed to go? Shit. Nothing over there. Oh! Oops. I don't think I can make that. Is there something I need to shoot? Ugh, where am I supposed to go? Try and turn it again? Oh, that's where I came from. Okay, hold on. Okay, if we go back up here. What is this thing? Well, there's nothing I can do over there, right? Am I supposed to go back this way? Usually it's like pretty linear. But these things have stopped, so maybe. Okay, this seems like pretty interesting way to go. Oh, come on! That's bullshit. That's such bullshit. Alright. Oh, what? The game just knows. Oh, what the fuck? Oh no, there's so many enemies. Oh, yes. Oh god, I had enough trouble facing one of these guys like on his own, like. Okay. Ha! 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 Okay, block! 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 No. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna fuck this guy up. Come on, hit me. Hit me! Oh! Throw something at me. Oh shit. Oh, ow. That fucking hurt. Alright, we're almost done. We're almost done. Oh! Shit, can you just throw something at me? There we go. Black! Black! Oh no, I missed the third one. Can you just... Why doesn't he hit his teammates? Fuck! Ow! Trying to switch targets. Look at me go, honestly. Like, I'm so... Fuck off! Ah! Oh, just in time. Can you just die, please? Jesus Christ! This is the weirdest thing! Oh my gosh. Oh, this is so difficult, kind of. It's just like... long. Frustrating. Like my wiener. Kidding. It's short and frustrating. There we go. Now I can chop. Choppity chop chop. Ha! Chop 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 chop. Fuck you! I'm so good at this game. Okay. Sorry about, like, not talking during that whole fucking thing. It's just that, I suck at talking and fighting. You might have seen in our, Cloudberry Kingdom, Let's Plays where I can't talk and go at the same time. I'm pretty good at that game. But I can't fucking talk. There's a lever in there. Can I get through here? Huh! Oh, it'd be awesome if you could jump and shrink at the same time. Oh, the fucking mouse guy is that way. How do I get in there? Oh, it'd be really awesome if I could fit through. Oh, is there something here? Nope. Where the fuck am I supposed to go? How do I get in there? Can't get on top. Can't. Oh, there we go. Oh, you guys probably saw that an hour ago. Yeah, I guess this is a good place to cap it off for this episode at 35 minutes. Oh, we're about to get the fucking... Is he the Mad Hatter? We're gonna get his legs. Yeah, so this was an anime-filled, advice-filled episode of Uncut with Dr. Alex fucking PhD of bullshit. Yeah, so hopefully you like that. I'm going to try and render out episode one again. And yeah, so thank you for watching if you did. And I'll see you on the next one. Subscribe, like, comment, tell me what anime you watch and what anime you want me to watch. And I'll do it because I love you. Oh, we got 8 out of... I hope we didn't miss any. All right, that's it. Good night.
Hang off, Missy. Move along.
All right. You have a fucked up accent. Big Nose Doug. Oh, never mind. You're Big Nose Doug. And that brings up the even, like, more conspirical? Is that a word? Conspiracy type deal where it's like, are they pretending to be humans?